Good morning once again. I'm Woodland Johnson. I'm the proud principal of Mort Elementary, a community school. Thank you, and I want to welcome you all this morning to the Hillsborough County Public Schools Back to School Press Conference. In a few minutes, you're going to hear from Superintendent Jeff Akins, but first I'd like to introduce our school board members who are here with us this morning. First of all, the Honorable School Board Chair, April Griffin. The Honorable Vice Chair, Cindy Stewart. The Honorable School Board Member, Doretha Edgecombe. And the Honorable School Board Member, Sally Harris. I would also like to take a moment to thank the staff here at Mort Elementary School for all of the hard work that they've done over the past 2 days getting ready for our event today. So all of my staff kind of wave as so we could recognize you and say thank you. They've done a tremendous job getting ready and getting prepared for today, so I thank them and as well as my assistant principals for all of the hard work that they put in the last couple of days and this weekend getting ready, so thanks to all of them. So I want to say that I'm thrilled that Superintendent Akins decided to choose Mort for the annual Back to School News Conference. We have so much to share, and we are so excited about all the new programs and opportunities and innovation that we have here at Mort Community School. As you know, the superintendent will be coming and sharing with you his and the school board's goals for this coming school year. But I remind you, please do not forget to stay with us after the press conference this morning, in which we will have our community school ribbon cutting to open up the new community school. The community school concept partners with community partners and local leaders to meet the needs of students and families, integrating the school community with health and wellness programs, community and parent outreach, enhanced educational opportunities, and empowering our students and our families. Thank you, and at this time, I'd like to please welcome up with me this morning, our school board chair, April Griffin. So welcome.
We have chosen such a wonderful principal for this school and for this concept. Thank you so much for having us here today. Hold on a second, here we go. And who's excited, first of all, to start this school year? I know we had an abbreviated summer, but that just means that we really didn't get out of the spirit of the school year, so I know that everybody's really excited to get back. Good morning, everyone, and thank you for being here at Mort Elementary, a community school to help us celebrate the start of a new school year. In particular, I'd like to thank the staff and leadership of Mort for hosting us today. I'd also like to thank the terrific students who are here. Thank you all so much for being here. If it were not for you, none of the people in this room would be here today. So you are the most important part of what we do every single day. I'd like to thank the superintendent, Mr. Akins, and his staff for their continued leadership in this district. Thank you so much. This has been a really exciting past year that we've had. And I'd also like to introduce our school board member, Ms. Susan Valdez. It's raining out there, so. Welcome. This is an exciting time for all of us, but especially the students. And in my own memory, I can remember the first day of school and how I was filled with excitement and anxiety, and yes, a little bit of dread. What kid really wants the summer to end? There were all kinds of new things to be excited about and worried about. New teachers, new schedules, new lockers, new classes, and maybe even a new school. For me, that was certainly the case. In spite of all the new things that might have made me worry, there was always the excitement of starting something important. I always knew that the first day of school was one more important step to being who I wanted to be. And I knew that the more steps I took, the more prepared for life that I would be. So I just kept taking those steps, every year taking those first steps. And that's how you become a lifelong learner. That's how you become who you want to be. As all of our students make those very first steps on Wednesday, let us remember to be encouraging and excited for them. And let's remember how many things there are to be anxious about. And let's remember that they, too, are just as excited as all of you are for them to be back in school. And because of that, let's all just take one more breath, one more second, and one more time out to show each other and our students a little extra kindness, courtesy, and patience. It's going to be a great school year, and I'm excited to serve these students every single day, just as I know my fellow board members are. Let's all be safe and start the school year off right. Thank you all so much for being here, and let's have a wonderful year.
Thank you so much, and it's going to be a great school year. At this time, I would like to welcome up Marcos Morello, our Area 2 Superintendent.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for having me here represent my great group of area superintendents. As you, all of you know, we have 8 area superintendents, and we represent the community. We're the hub of the community, and we're here to actually be the bridge between the schools and our offices and the district. We are here to support the community, the parents, and we encourage all of you to actually have good communications with our teachers and our schools. And if you need anything for us to support, please contact the office. We're here at all times, and we're here to actually build the capacity of our school administrators to support our students and provide all the academic needs that they need. Please, again, I encourage that communication so we can help at all times and support and prepare students for life. Thank you.
And now, please help me welcome our superintendent, Jeff Akins.
What an amazing school, and what an amazing leader at an amazing school, right? You got a big fan club, Mr. Johnson, just so you know. It's growing by the second. Well, thank you, Principal Johnson. I'd also like to again recognize our amazing school board who has been so supportive of our administration. Thank you, board members, for all you do to help us prepare our students for life. I'm thrilled to be here, and I'm so excited for the start of the school year. It feels like yesterday, and almost was, that I was shaking the hands of our graduates, wishing them well and excited that we had prepared them to succeed in life. The last year has really flown by for me. During my first full year as superintendent, we went through a lot of growth and change as a district, but now my full team is in place. And I ask my staff and our area superintendents to please stand at this time to be recognized. We went through a lengthy interview process to ensure we have the right people in place for the success of our students and to support our employees. Last year, we introduced the district's strategic plan and 4 strategic priorities. We are excited because this plan will now guide us and allow us to focus on these priorities. One of our biggest goals is to increase our graduation rates. By the year 2020, we are aiming for our graduation rate to be 90%. It's been unheard of in a district this size, but it will happen because of the people in Hillsborough County. We know this is ambitious, but certainly achievable. Why? Because our students deserve the best. This year, we are also focusing on putting a system of support in place for all of our teachers. Every teacher will receive the support they need, when they need it, at their school site, so they can best meet the needs of the most important client we serve, our students. At our joint principals meeting just 3 weeks ago, I encouraged our leaders to create innovation, and I challenged them to think differently. Why? Because our students deserve the best. Our ultimate goal is to always improve student success. While the number of F schools in the district dramatically went down from the last year, we know that as professionals, we will not accept that outcome. The faculties at these schools, as well as every staff across this district, are committed to excellence and we will move forward and create 250-plus schools that are outstanding, meeting the needs of students every single day in Hillsborough County. The staff at all of our schools have tenacity. They are persistent. They are determined. Yes, they're patient and purposeful when it comes to our students. We will ensure we have resources for all of our schools, especially our schools that are struggling. Our Elevate schools, in particular, will have the benefit of being within our areas that are led by our area superintendents, who have the expert knowledge and the passion for high-need schools. Why? Because our students deserve the best. I am honored to lead the 8th largest school district in the nation. We expect to have more than 210,000 clients walk through our doors in just 2 days. They are at the heart of what we do and why we come to work every day. In fact, we have a few of our amazing students here today, and I'd like to join them and talk with them about their goals as their plan and their plans for this year. So I'm going to make a transition here. Let's see if I have my Phil Donahue expertise with me here. So I'm going to move over, kind of sit in the middle. So representing us here today is really the whole continuum of early childhood all the way to our graduates of this year in 2017. So with that, I'm going to take a seat kind of in the middle, see if I'm coordinated. Yes, I am. All right, so first of all, I'm going to have Mr. Reyes move over just that way just a little bit, because we have a star here I want to introduce to you. This is Mr. DeSatrius. He's a student here at Mort Elementary. Now, he went through his kindergarten year last year, and he was pretty amazing. We have his teacher up here, Ms. Snellgrove. Thank you, Ms. Snellgrove, for joining us today. So, DeSatrius, so last year in kindergarten, I heard you learned your ABCs. Is that correct? You want to say them? I think he does.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
So just so you know, I was talking to DeSatrius before, and he's already reading books, as you can already tell. He knows his letters. He knows his sounds. He had some amazing teachers to be able to do that with him here at Mort. And you, whoever your first grade teacher is going to be this year, they're going to be extremely lucky, for DeSatrius. So let's give it up again for DeSatrius. So obviously the foundational years are critical for our students to receive the very best education possible in order to set them on that trajectory for success. And sometimes in the middle of those elementary years, it becomes a very critical point in time, that third grade year. And we need to ensure that our students, when they get out of our third grade classrooms, that they are already reading, because we know what happens next, because there's a lot of learning to do after that with all the different subject areas. So I'm very honored to have one of the amazing third grade teachers here at Mort Elementary, Mr. Reyes, joining us here today. Mr. Reyes, how are you doing?
Fantastic.
Excellent. All right, well, Mr. Reyes, obviously in order for students to be successful in elementary or wherever they are in their schooling, they need to be equipped with some very specific strategies. So as a third grade teacher, what are some strategies that you feel like students need to possess?
I need this for my class. It would really work. But anyway, we grow our kids socially, emotionally, and academically. And socially is huge. If anybody noticed the men of vision when they walked through this door, I mean, they stood out to me as soon as I walked through the door. And in thinking about that, I said, wow, a lot of times as a third grade teacher, I assume that kids know certain things. We want to make them leaders. We want to do this and that. But we have to teach them those things, simple things like making eye contact, shaking hands, yes sir, no sir, and meeting these gentlemen, like they stood out to me. So that's one thing that we really work on hard is just those social skills. You know, when you sneeze, you know, do a little dab, you know, things like that. You know, all those things are super essential for our kids, and it's gonna carry them in life. These guys stand out. And for me, being a math teacher, you know, we teach everything. We teach the whole child, but foundational skills. Those foundational skills are essential. I just graduated with my master's this weekend, so I'm super excited. Thank you. Never thought I would do that, but being in a higher education math class, I was the odd man out. So I'm in these math classes with these mathematicians, and I was scared, and I didn't know. And they assumed that there was a certain level of knowledge there that I might have forgotten. And a little aha popped in my head. In my own classroom, how many times has this happened? I assume there's a certain level of knowledge there, but I can't assume that. And it's my job to get that out. So those foundational skills, I need to make sure that we hone in on them, number sense. I mean, do they know what a digit is? Do they know that the value of that digit in a whole number? I can't teach them multiplication, division, fractions if they don't know what a number is, you know? And those are the steps we take as third grade teachers.
Awesome. Obviously, Mr. Reyes is one of just several of the amazing Manatee teachers here, and I know some of them are here today to cheer him on. But obviously, you do create that foundation that's so critical because that third grade year is so important for our students. So many statistics nationwide are built off of the success or failure of our students in third grade. So it's important for us to get them through those years, and thank you for what you do every single day, Mr. Reyes, here at Mort Elementary School. All right, I'm going to move on to fifth grade now. I was a fifth grade teacher, so this is a big grade for me, okay? And we have Miss Ansley up here. She's from McFarland Park. And one of the things about being a fifth grader, Ansley, is you're kind of the big person on campus, right? You're the oldest group. Is that pretty special?
I guess.
Well, it will be special for you this year. So one of the things, obviously, we've been talking a lot about in Hillsborough County is leadership, ensuring that our students have the ability to show leadership. Even though you might be 10 or 11 years of age, you can still be a leader on your campus. So how are you going to show your leadership skills at McFarland Park this year?
Well, this year I plan to go to the morning show for my third year where we tell other kids about what's going on campus. And then we also do this thing at school called Reading Buddies where I read to a younger kid and I help them read too. So
you're like a teacher. All right. Well, what do you think about that? Great leadership? Sometimes other students like their peers working with them, and obviously a fifth grader and all the students look up to you, Ansley. So don't ever think that just because you might be 10 or 11 doesn't mean you don't have those leadership skills to make a difference in the life of kids. So take full advantage of that. I know Ms. Rivera is very proud of you out there at McFarland Park today. So I'm going to move on to a critical year, the transition year between fifth grade and sixth grade. Obviously, making that transition is not always easy. Our families sometimes have a little struggle with that moving into middle school for their students. But I have an all-star here, a former Mort Manatee, Mr. Giovanni Reyes, joining me up here today. He's going to be making the transition from Mort Elementary to Walker IB. Congratulations. So in that transition, Giovanni, obviously, you know, the teachers at Walker need to know kind of what are those subjects, what are those things that really get you motivated. So what are some of your favorite subjects that you're going to be studying this year?
Math and reading.
Okay. All right. Hear everything out there with those Walker teachers, math and reading. This is the guy to go to. So, you know, sometimes, though, reading and math, obviously, we want you to be successful, but there could be other things on campus to get students connected, to get them excited about coming to school. So what's another thing you told me earlier you're going to hopefully get connected with over at Walker?
Well, I'm going to try to convince my mom if she could get me in the soccer team there. And then
play soccer. There you go. So some of the things we sometimes forget is, the reading and the math is very important for our kids to stay connected. But sometimes it's those extracurricular activities that we offer our students, and that helps them to stay connected and be more excited about coming to school each and every day. So in Hillsborough County, we have to make sure we offer an array of programs for our students. And in middle school, I know athletics, the arts, all those types of extracurricular activities are so important for our students to get connected. So good luck over at Walker. I know you're going to do amazing things. Just like you did here at Moore, Giovanni.
Thank you.
All right. Speaking of transitions, I am about to introduce to you the first person that you've been introduced to the class of 2020. Okay? This is our class that we know that our goals are set in 2020 to reach that 90% graduation rate. And I have an amazing young man here, Colin Spain, who was a student at Franklin Boys Prep the last few years. And he is making the transition to Tampa Bay Tech this year for his ninth grade year. Now, I understand you've got big plans in your life because he's going to go into the ROTC program over at TBT. All right. So you know how we sometimes think students set, maybe lower bar goals in their life. This young man wants to be a Navy SEAL. Okay, so obviously he set the bar pretty high. But obviously those kinds of goals, don't come easy to achieve. So ninth grade, we've talked about year after year, is a critical time in moving into your ninth grade year. So what are you going to be doing in ninth grade to make sure that you stay on track and be successful to ultimately achieve those goals?
Well, first off, I'll keep up with my work and make sure I'm self-disciplined in classes and build up great relationship with my teachers and also with my peers so we can have a successful year. And lastly, I would like to also involve my family and Men of Vision with myself because it's a partnership that involves everyone.
Very good. Excellent. So he's identified key stakeholders in his success. It's not just all on his shoulders, right? He's talked about the purpose that we serve as educators, as teachers are going to serve to ensure that he's successful. And he's going to surround himself with peers that are going to help him be accountable for reaching his goals, and ultimately his family, who he is going to be held accountable by as well. So, Colin, I wish you the very best. I have a feeling that in 4 years, when we're all celebrating that 90% goal, you are going to be one part of that 90%. Congratulations. And speaking of graduates, so with me today, we have a senior at the STEM Pre-Collegiate Academy at Middleton High School. Welcome, Paola. So, Paola, first of all, congratulations on just being in the STEM Academy there. It's pretty amazing. I know engineering is a big possible future career. What is the next steps for you?
So after high school, I plan on attending a four-year university, and I plan on majoring in mechanical engineering, well, dual majoring in mechanical engineering and pure mathematics.
Okay. You just made your mother very proud out there, just so you know, Paola. Now, you just didn't just overnight just become this star, STEM Pre-Collegiate Academy student at Middleton High School. Obviously, there was a lot of things along the way that led you to this point in your life. Talk to me a little bit about kind of how you got to this point.
Sure. So in elementary school, I really excelled in mathematics and science, and my father was an engineer, so he always pushed me towards that direction. Later in middle school, I knew that was an important thing to choose, and so I went to Greco Middle School for their STEM program that specialized in engineering. And from there, I got a little bit of taste of what it was, and I learned that I wanted to do more of it. So from there, I chose Middleton High School because they do have a STEM engineering program. And there, I've learned more topics about thermodynamics, statics. And so from there, I decided that I wanted to be a mechanical engineer.
Amazing. Amazing. And so when Paola walks across the stage for her graduation this year, she's also going to be graduating with her AA degree. Correct? Pretty impressive. What do you think of these students and teacher? So from the Satris to Paola, to all of our students in between, we have to provide all the resources necessary. We have to provide great teachers in our schools, no matter where our students land on Wednesday. Everyone opens up their classrooms and remembers that every single one of these students have dreams. Every single one of the students that come into your classrooms this year will have dreams. And so in order to help them to achieve their dreams, just like Paola is about ready to achieve her dreams, just like Colin someday will be that Navy SEAL, you know, we have students that are walking through our doors that will have the same opportunity someday to achieve those goals. So it takes a village. It takes everyone to do this. It takes an amazing leadership team. It takes amazing teachers. It takes support staff across this district. It takes our parents to be involved, our communities to be involved, our partners to be involved in order for us to be successful. If we're ever going to even use the words 90% graduation rate, if we're ever going to say that, we have to, first of all, believe it can be attained. And I believe with the collective power of everybody in this room, from our teachers to our leaders to our district staff, we're going to achieve that goal. And we're going to ensure that every single one of the students that come into our doors will be able to achieve like these students have achieved. So are you all in? Okay. Everyone in? Good. It's an amazing journey every year that when we go on this, but certainly over these next several years, it's going to be amazing for our students and for this community. So with that, I just want to thank everyone for being here today, and I know that our press is here today, so is there any questions that anyone would like to ask at this time for our press conference?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Sarah with Bay News 9. Can you elaborate on reaching that 90% graduation rate and kind of what you guys have in place to get there?
Sure. Well, as I said earlier, the first thing you have to have in order to reach the 90% graduation rate is amazing people. Amazing people, amazing partners in every single one of our classrooms. That's like a non-negotiable across Hillsborough County Public Schools. 16,000 teachers strong, amazing principals, amazing leaders. So that's where we start. Secondly, then, we have to know these students. I mean, they're our clients. We just can't say, well, we believe this is what's important for you to learn. We have to, first of all, get to know them so we know what do they still need to learn. So obviously, doing a lot of our pre-assessment and understanding our students' needs is critical for us to ever think about reaching a goal of 9% graduation rate. And then we have to provide the resources, the programs, the opportunities for our students to stay connected in their schooling throughout their high school years, through their elementary, middle, truly get them engaged around their curriculum and around those kinds of opportunities. And can't forget those extracurricular activities like Giovanni's going to get involved with at his school as well to help him stay connected. Then beneath that, we have to have systems. We have to have systems to truly track that particular, the success of our students. And what I talked about at the joint principals meeting with all our leaders, we have to have an amazing amount of tenacity. That means we cannot give up on one student. One student is 0.0007. Think about that. And I said at the joint principals meeting, now if for some people that may not mean something, but if it was your student, if it was your child, if it was me, that would mean a lot. So we have to go into every single day thinking that 0.007 is our child or us. So everything that's going to take to help DeSatrius be successful in first grade, for Giovanni to be successful in sixth grade, for Ansley to be successful in fifth grade, for Colin to be successful in ninth grade, and Paola to finish out her senior year at Middleton High School, we're going to need that tenacity. We're going to need that type of purposeful support for our students to not give up on them. And then we're going to have to have strong data systems, as I said, to make sure we're tracking and keeping ourselves, to make course corrections along the way if necessary. Hey, hi, Marley.
Hi. Mr. Eggins, your chief of transportation, Jim Beekman, said recently that last year's return to school was the worst he has ever experienced in a career that goes back to 1983. Now, he said this after describing a lot of work he has done, mm-hmm. a lot of steps he has taken to improve things for this year, including a call center for parents who are concerned and a lot of other steps. How confident are you right now in the transportation system for the first day of school, and what should parents keep in mind
Sure.
on Wednesday?
So let me contextualize his comment a little bit. First of all, Mr. Beekman's been an amazing leader across the entire space that he's ever served in transportation. So he's had some pretty incredible opening days for him because of his expertise. That's why he's here, by the way, in Hillsborough County. We wanted to draw someone who had a lens for what we needed. Obviously, at the beginning of last year, there were several things. That was his first opening here in Hillsborough County. He saw some things immediately that needed to be addressed. Routing was extremely critical, that we get all the routing so that we're very efficient out on the roads. By the way, roads that aren't always just traffic free. You know, we have to make sure we have the best routes to all of our destinations, to our stops, in order for our pickup times to be on time. So getting the routing in place, getting all the support systems in place for them to be able to track those routes. Communication was critical for the transportation department to really work on, and they heard that from our board at several meetings to talk about ways to improve transportation communication with families, with schools, to ensure that everyone kind of understand it's an imperfect system no matter how you look at it because of the nature of transportation. You're going to deal with rain. You're going to deal with issues that come up every single day that you may not have controls over, but we have to be in control of what we can control. And so that's what Mr. Beekman and his staff has really worked on. I will tell you what, I don't know if you were able at all to go to the opening day of our transportation staff over at the fairgrounds this year, but they are charged up. That I will tell you, it was 1,600 strong of just a room full of miracle workers, I'll be honest with you, because of, if you think of the task that they have to do every single day, not only keep drive a bus that not all of us any of us in this room maybe perhaps can do, but do it with 60 to 70 students on board, keeping in mind the traffic that's coming at them. I mean, it's an amazing lift that they perform every single day in Hillsborough County to assist our students and our families to get them to school. I have tremendous confidence in what they've put in place, Marlene. They really have thought about the system as a whole, the communication, the routing. But I will tell you what I'm even more amazed about with our transportation staff is he is building 1,600 staff workers about advocating for kids. That is really what he wants them to think about their role is. Just like every single one of our people in our buildings are thinking about advocating for students every day. What an amazing opportunity we have when we pick up our students in the morning to be the very first one to greet them and start them their day off on a great note, you know, just to say hello, get to know them, and really kind of develop that relationship. I know I had a great crew of bus drivers at my schools where I was a teacher and an administrator. It's a game changer, truly, when you have everyone, including your transportation staff, working to advocate for students. You're welcome.
On. Hello. Oh, there you go. I'm Beatrice with Infomas News. This school specifically, I believe, and correct me if I'm wrong, has a high number of Hispanic students. Many of them, you know, speak Spanish at home, and then they come here speak English, and I know that can be a challenge. With this, you know, change to being a community school, are you guys going to tackle this at all, help these specific families?
That is a great question. Stay for the next part of our agenda. For the ribbon cutting, you'll probably even find out even more that's going to be happening to support our students. So this is the amazing thing about a community school is, you know, first of all, whenever you're working with students and families who are facing some challenges, obviously learning a language, perhaps there could be financial challenges or finding homes and settling and having stability in your life. There's a whole host of challenges that our families are facing in at schools, just like Mort. So obviously providing them the education that they so richly deserve, that is first and foremost for the teachers here and the staff here at Mort Elementary School. But beyond that, some of the challenging needs that our students and our families bring every single day are just not, we just don't have enough of those resources in our schools to be able to help overcome those barriers. Health challenges, social services challenges. Perhaps there are families who also don't know the language and want to better themselves. And that's what the community school concept is all about. It's breaking down those barriers, leveling the playing field for our families and our students to help them to ultimately be successful. And yes, offer extra classes to assist the families and the students to learn the language more more proficiently, to perhaps allow the families to get a job, to get work that could better themselves. And then to have all these great partners that you have, that I see here in this room around us, I just want you to know I'm humbled, because we say all the time in a large district like this, we cannot do it alone. And they are stepping up to the plate, and they are showing that they are going to partner with this district to help every single one of our students be successful here at Mort. And with the leadership that we have in Mr. Johnson kind of being in the driver's seat here at Mort, it's going to be an amazing support system that's going to be surrounding our students and families. Well, with that, I want to thank everyone again for being here. We will be here after the press conference if you need to meet with any of us one-on-one. Thank you, Mort Elementary. Thank you so much for being our host. Woo. I wish you the very best opening day. I know the rain is coming because manatees need lots of water to make it to school. So you'll have plenty of water to get here by Wednesday, just so they shut off the valve by the time they get here. Woodland, that'll be a great thing. But I wish everyone a great opening to the school. Everyone out there, have a great first day on Wednesday. Thank you.